Here's another popular limit example. Evaluate the limit as x approaches 0 for sine of 2x over 7x. And oftentimes these numbers 2 and 7 will be changed. There'll be different values here. Before I begin this problem, let me actually scroll down and introduce you to two well-known limits. These are two limits that we just need to have memorized. You can evaluate them in other ways, numerically or graphically or whatnot, but most people just have these memorized. The limit of sine x over x as x approaches 0. You notice if you just try to plug in 0, sine of 0 is 0 divided by 0, you get an indeterminate form. So you keep looking, you keep looking. There's not really too much algebra you could do to either one of these guys without doing something pretty fancy. So if you just look at the limit numerically for x values around 0, which it will be evaluated or able to be evaluated around 0, you plug in 0.1, 0.2, negative 0.1, negative 0.2, and it's pretty clear that this limit will be 1. But let's just memorize that quantity. And similarly, the limit as x approaches 0 for 1 minus cosine x over x, that limit will be 0. Now, when you take calc 2, there's actually a very nice way to evaluate limits like this with these indeterminate forms called L'Hopital's rule, but that'll come sometime later. But for now, we'll just recognize these as we see them. Right now, this one kind of looks like that first rule, but I see so many bad algebra steps when students try to evaluate this and try to make it look like sine x over x. The most common one, and this is very wrong, but a lot of times students will want to pull out the 2 and pull out the 7 and get like a 2/7 out here, but that's bad algebra. The sine basically locks down, excuse me, locks down the 2x, and the 2 is not allowed to come outside of the sine. So that's out. That's not an option. What we can do, though, is we could pull out a 1/7. That's fine. You could pull out a 1/7 and get rid of this 7. But we still have sine 2x over x. So the trick is this. Since the 2 is locked down and can't go anywhere, and it'll have to stay there or remain there, we can add in an additional 2 in the denominator. Now, really, that's like adding a 1/2 to the problem, if you can see that 1/2 there. It's not actually a factor of 2, it's a factor of a half. Now, if you put a half inside the limit, we would want to balance that on the outside with a positive 2. Now, why do we do that? Well, now we would have 2/7 times the limit as x approaches 0 for sine of blank over blank. Now the key is that these guys are the same. If what's inside the sine and what's in the denominator match, then as x goes to 0, they're both going to be going to 0, and they'll even be going to 0 at the same rate. So as long as these match, it doesn't have to perfectly fit this template. It's an equivalent format of this template. To explain it one other way, as you could say sine 2x over 2x as 2x goes to 0, but if 2x went to 0, then obviously that means the x would be going to 0 as well. So any way you decide to think about it, this limit right here matches that special limit that I showed you previously. So your final answer is 2/7 times 1. So you do get 2/7 for your final answer. But this is one of those funny times where students will often get the right answer using a bad path or a bad algebraic path. So if you got 2/7 by pulling out a 2 and pulling out a 7, on a test, this would be counted incorrect, just as if you had answered it with a completely wrong answer, because the logic was not correct. So just make sure that your logic progression is accurate throughout the problem, and you'll get problems like this correct.